eastern side of downtown Minneapolis at the gorgeous new U.S. Bank Stadium. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the New Orleans Saints and the Minnesota Vikings. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. First carry for Adrian Peterson, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Again, Peterson, and not a whole lot doing there, as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a third and seven. A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is third and seven. On third down, Bradford finding time. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. Fielded at the 20. And he is out of bounds, getting it across the 30-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. They come out here in the eye. Breeze now on first down. And it's caught, Kobe Flaner. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. And give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. From midfield, here's Breeze. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Now the offense lining up first and 10.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Again, they'll run with Ingram. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down. For Ingram, he topped the 1,000-yard mark this year for the first time in his 6-year career.
Didn't he just come out of Alabama last
year? That's what it feels like, right?
I mean, it's amazing.
6 seasons he's had.
Won a Heisman Trophy there, finally over 1,000 yards.
And this is caught inside the 5. And he's brought down after a good game.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football.
And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Mark Ingram taking it in. And the Saints have taken the early lead. And Charles, he's able to dive in there in a short yardage situation.
Just find a place to get to the end zone. Didn't matter where it was, but once he did, used his nose for the end zone and dove in.
So this drive spans 7 plays, and it's Mark Ingram who caps it off with a touchdown run. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. You know, for this Vikings team, as they come back out here on offense, I don't know that any group had more of a roller coaster ride than them in the 2016 season. The quarterback change at the beginning, the hot start, and then the cold middle. It was just a tough year for them, wasn't it?
It really was, and when you look at how their season went, you mentioned the roller coaster. A lot of it can come back to the injuries, especially along the offensive line. I think by around October, maybe even early November, I'm surprised you and I didn't get a call to go audition to be a left tackle there because they were just down so many guys. So that made it difficult to run the ball and to protect Sam Bradford, their quarterback, and it reflected in their final record.
That one goes for 24 yards.
I'm just looking side by side at Diggs' number, rookie year versus sophomore year, a season ago. 52 catches as a rook, 84 last year, but something you pointed out to me, yards per catch is off a bit, isn't it?
It is, and you know, his first year, he was known a little bit more as a big play threat. This past season, adjusting to a new quarterback in Sam Bradford, that number went down by about 3 yards per catch, but he can be an explosive type of a receiver. Look at the last two games of the regular season, well over 100 yards in both.
They come out here in the eye. On second down, Peterson. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. On the stop, Stephon Anthony with a tackle.
Brandon, I know you play the fantasy football game, and Adrian Peterson has to be a popular pick for owners. But this year, a tough season for him. A knee injury early limited him to 72 yards total for the season.
Yeah, early indeed. Week two on that knee injury. So 72 yards, as you said, for the year. Came back admirable, hoping to get him into the playoffs, but didn't look like he was ready to return.
One guy I never count out, though, is Adrian Peterson. I expect a monster return in 2017.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. 2 seconds to go, first quarter. They'll run with Ingram here to begin the drive. And he'll be taken down here as it will take us. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Saints football to begin quarter number two. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Ingram again. A strong running. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A gain of four that time as the drive continues.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. It's almost a tendency breaker.
They go play action here on first down. And Cooks hands it over the middle. Touchdown, New Orleans. Brandon Cooks, 67 yards. And the Saints add on to their lead.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post route?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
And it's good to make it 14-0. So they only needed 3 plays on that drive. And it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
The Saints defense ready to set up shop again here. They'll be hoping to come up with that same type of effort they had last time when they forced the punt that led to a touchdown.
And that type of effort just continues to carry over because once you get it done once, you feel like you can do it again and again. It's no guarantee, but you got to like the confidence that they take back out into the field.
Now will they keep that confidence? Time to find out. And he's going to get hit at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really at the point of attack, the offensive line is just getting pushed around. I think now as a play caller, you've got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence because you can't abandon the play calling right now. With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
Bradford from the gun on third down. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Here's Jeff Locke now as he's on to punt for Minnesota.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And this is picked up by the Saints.
And that's what friends are for.
Right. As the returner, you know who you're buying dinner for later.
Oh, without a doubt, because he just took care of you and your team in a big way. You know, you turn it over there, that's a big momentum changer and put your defense in a bad spot.
The drive starts here with a carry by Ingram. And he'll get two, maybe three, up near the 37. Give the tackle there to Terrence Newman. 7 yards to go on second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draw.
He's got a man complete. A good pick up there, 26 yards. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. More from Minneapolis after this. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Larry Ridley will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. This is Ingram on first and 10. And he's going to be taken down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
I know back in the good old days, just about every team was constructed to power run to the right side. We just saw a pitch to the right side that worked pretty well.
It's easier going to the right than the left?
It just used to be very simply that the right side was always the power side. I think that's just one of those old things. I'm not sure it's still the same, but on that play, it certainly felt like we were back to the future.
Yeah, and it worked. Second down following the run.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Brandon Cooks, the receiver he was going after. And it's third down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will actually break your heart. They had everything they wanted.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Their big-bodied receiver, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. And 3 and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul-searching now?
I would say so. They need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots. But
now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Peterson alone in the backfield. Second down, Bradford. He rifles one that's intercepted. Delvin Brown with a pick. And the return will be stopped.
Well, the timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Now the Saints, they trot their offense out here. Breeze now to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Xavier Rhodes with a pick. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Bradford off the play fake to Peterson. He's got time in the pocket. He's going to let this one go deep. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Sterling Moore. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Breeze gives it up to Ingram. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And now they're in the hurry-up. Breeze to throw on second down. He's going to fire one deep, middle of, and that's caught inside the 35. That goes for a gain of 31. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from it. And he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime. We have two quarters to turn it around.
Hey, Charles, can you give me a water? Jeez, Chuck, they cut off the halftime show again. Quicker than anticipated, ready for the start of the second half. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Here's Breeze to throw. Rolling to his right. Now he's going to throw it back deep over the middle. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
A nickelback added defensively as they look to stop this third and eight. Now Breeze on third down. Now Breeze lost the football. And fortunately for him, he's able to get it back, but it will be a loss on the play.
Well, that was a big oops right there. But how about his ability to correct it? Loses the football, able to get it back himself.
Yeah, pounced right back on it, keeps possession. Here's Thomas Morstead now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. And that's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And it'll be Viking football here as they take possession. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because no, tell me.
That's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two. though they held him to a short gain on that one. And it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
Now Bradford on second down. And he will find his man on the outside. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
That was a nice completion on an out route. And those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
Play fake here on first down, surveying the field, and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
Hand off comes to Peterson, and he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Bradford, a dump down to McKinnon. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
Well, that's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. How does the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here? And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Decent chunk of yardage still left here. 2nd and 7.
You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and, you know, what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead, staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation that we're not really focused on it.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion.
And he still doesn't have a catch. We're into the second half. I think it's a little bit of a surprise to me, but that was one he should have caught.
Absolutely. That was his best opportunity right there. He dropped it. Give him 3 yards there as that'll take us to fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. And now the up man has it. It's a fake. And he will not even make it back to the line of scrimmage. So following the failed try on fourth down, we'll change ends and change possession. We'll return with more after this. Back now at beautiful new U.S. Bank Stadium. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. Bradford on first down and complete. Right side, the tight end Rudolph. The completion good for 3 and it's 2nd down. So they complete the pass and now they face a 2nd down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. He'll get forward for 3 down to the 16-yard line. Craig Robertson in on the stop.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Now Peterson, and he is going to lose yardage here. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4. And they have really been able to contain AP, and because of it, they've got the lead here in the 4th.
And they've done a really nice job in this game. A lot of group tackling. Rare that one guy gets him on the ground consistently. They've done an excellent job of containing him in this game.
And he's able to find Diggs. It'll be a gain of 18 on the play. And the decision to go for it pays off. They've got a first and goal. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
What a game this defense has played. They're pitching a shutout, so it'd be fun to watch down the stretch to see if their defensive coordinator continues to be as aggressive as he's been all game long.
Here's McKinnon, and he will take this one into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. Jarek McKinnon taking it in from 4 yards out, and the Vikings are able to close the gap just a bit. And there you go, nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football, good blocking, beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they could somehow get this one back. And the Saints hands team able to rein this one in. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
He's got time. He's going to loft one deep left side here. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10. Breeze is looking to throw. That is caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Josh Hill, 26 yards. And the Saints add on to their lead. They had the lead in the fourth, but still passing. Finding the big target for the touchdown. Now that lead grows even more.
Everybody gets to join in the fun. You know, it doesn't have to just be the wide receivers catching touchdown passes. The tight end doesn't just have to do just the dirty work inside. He gets a chance to get into the end zone as well.
A drive there of just four plays. And it all culminates in a Saints touchdown. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. And now out comes Minnesota. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that, and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team, and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done, and maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
On second down, Bradford again. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. He was looking for Adam Thielen there. Third down here. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion.
So much of his game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's...
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. A great read, and it's picked off. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line.
Partner's bad enough when you just can't hold on to the football. But when your quarterback's throwing it to the other team, that's three interceptions now, four turnovers for the game. you really have no chance to win the football game.
He's gonna, and that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, New Orleans. Brandon Cooks. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But another thing that always hits me is, are they worried about...
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Throwing again, Bradford on 2nd and 10. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a 4th pick, and it's 3rd down. So a ways to go here on 3rd and 10.
Well, an incomplete pass certainly doesn't look like a good play. For the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's got to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction.
And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down. Here's Jeff Locke now, as he's on for the 5th time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. He'll look to set up his blockers. Good blocking there, nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Saints will take over with a 1st down and 10. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. They have the big cushion here in the final stages of this one. I don't know if there's any better feeling than being up big on the road.
There really can't be, because for a team to go on the road and win in the NFL, that's huge to begin with. But just think about all the preparation that went into it. When they first started talking about this game, leading up to it during the week, going on the road, unfamiliar city, obviously, unfamiliar hotel. No one's going to be with you once you get to the stadium. They're all going to be against you. You name.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll try to run for the first with Ingram. And he will have the 1st down as he's brought down up near midfield. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. 3rd and 2 is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward to get the 1st down.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8. On 2nd down, Ingram. And he showed some fancy footwork on the juke, but then quickly taken down. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room.